So, have you looked at the steam market recently? I did, and there's something pretty odd to watch. We have the Stockholm Dust2, and not only Dust2, we also have Ancient, we have Mirage, we have all of these going up in price insanely fast. And you might have wondered, should I also get some of these? I mean, if you go in-game and you go to Stockholm and get more tokens, you can buy a token for €2.50. And that token you can redeem for a souvenir case. So, why isn't everybody doing this? In reality, everybody is actually trying to do this right now, and they probably wasted a lot of money for these souvenir cases. Why waste, when it's clearly profit? Because these cases come with a trade cooldown after receiving them. Sadly, my Steam is still in German, but you can look at my inventory with your own client if you don't believe me, and will see that it says not tradable until the 13th of November. So, why is this an issue? Because if you try to do this right now, 10,000s of people that already bought them for this reason will be faster than you. And when the stock increases rapidly, it results in massive price drops. But if that's the case, why did I call this video How to Profit from It? Let me show you. We will find the answer to this question over here in the Steam market. We will be looking at the 2090 and at the 2070 souvenir cases for this. I am well aware that these souvenir cases function differently. You couldn't just buy these for 250. You had to get them from like viewer drops. You had to watch the matches and there were limited drops. Anyway, they will follow the same principle as the ones right now. They will become unobtainable at some point. Back then, that point was reached once the major was done and there were no more matches. No more matches meant no more drops. No drops meant no more supply of these cases. And the same goes this year. Because after the 20th of November, you won't be able to redeem your souvenir tokens anymore, which means the supply will end, and these are consumables. Let's see what happened to these consumables. Month after month, for year, they kept increasing. Obviously, new major cases, so they dropped a little bit, but they started at 250, similar to the cases we have right now. They ended up at around 10 euro right now. Let's look at the Inferno ones, for example. Pretty similar. Let's look at the 270 Nuke ones, a little bit older. Started at 450 for euro, that's where the Mirage and Dust2s are right now. And some years later, we have nearly 40 euro. Over here, we look at the Mirage one, the same thing. It happens again and again and again. We can see a similar effect if we look at older cases. If you look at the older case, you will see the price increase over the time. Normally, you have to wait like 1 or 2 years or maybe longer for it to increase in price. This is because they are consumables. I made a pretty good video about that. You can check it out if you click on the info card right now if you want to know more about this. If you already know why these increase in price, you know that the souvenir case will see the same effect, and we already have deadline when the supply will end. So get into investing into those right now and don't sell them in like a week or two when everybody does it. Wait for it. Keep them. Trust me, you will regret it if you insta sell them. But what else do you need to know before you get into investing in those? So, let's imagine you got your tokens. Now, if you press redeem tokens, you can here pick quarterfinals, group stage, and all that kind of stuff. You're going to look for a promising game. Like, let's say, Navi versus Vitality. Why are we looking for this game? Because if you redeem a case from a match between these two, like Navi and Vitality, it is guaranteed that you will have a Navi and Vitality sticker on the gun that you get out of the package. This can rise the price of the package. And so you should not get something like, let's look, Challenger Stage. You shouldn't get some like this. You don't want to get Dailu and Movistar Riders. You don't want to do this. You don't want to get Sharks Esport, for example. You don't want to get some of the teams that didn't perform well this major. You want the top teams, the creme de la creme. You want Navi. You want G2. If you want, I don't know, maybe even Virtus Pro or Heroic. You want the good teams, the teams that showed off. Maybe even NiP. Maybe FaZe. You want teams that showed something. You want teams that are known. And once you find them, let's go back to semifinals. We have Navi Gambit is good, also this is good. If you found them, you click redeem a souvenir from this match. Make sure you see it in the background. You also see it on the left side that it's the map you want to have. I recommend get the new ones, get Mirage, get Dust2, and maybe even Vertigo. Vertigo right now is by far the cheapest from them, but the imminent danger is so unpopular that it's going to go through the roof in price. And once it's through the roof in price, people will open up its case again. Once people open up the case, the supply gets lower. Once the supply gets lower, the price will get higher and higher and maybe catch up, if not go over the one of the Mirage. Don't get Overpass, don't get Nuke. Why not? I believe there are great collections, I really like the skins in there. The thing is, we already had the skins from there in older cases. So there's more supply in general to get these skins than with the new collections from Riptide. So let's say we want Navi Gambit, stickers, Mirage, we click redeem a souvenir from this match, get souvenir. Now we have a new case in our inventory. Keep hold on to them, don't sell them, and wait for a little bit. Another really important thing you need to remember. If you want to invest into souvenir, please invest into the cases. Why not the skins? I've made a playskin guide. You will see in the playskin guide a lot of weapons and ways to invest into playskins. And investing into playskins is great, because you can play the gun while you keep the investment in round, and you have more of it than just a collectible in your inventory. But the problem with these souvenirs, let's look a little bit down, souvenir UMP Fade. We will see the prices around 80 euro. Even though it has such nice and expensive stickers on it, we will see very, very low prices here. Now, let's look at the non-souvenir version. We will see way higher prices, and I can show you why that is. So, we are in my inventory now, and as you can see, I've got some of the souvenir skins from my souvenir opening. Make sure to check that out if you want to see me suffer. And we will be looking at, let's say, this one for example. So, do you see something? Something pointing out to you. Let's, for example, for the Riptide case, press the dual berettas. Use with trade up contract. We cannot do this with the souvenir things. And let me scrap the stickers real quick, because even if I do this, so even though we remove the stickers, it's still a souvenir MP7 prey, and we still cannot trade up it. So the problem, as you can see now, is that they can't be trade up, and a lot of value for these pink, purples and all like that, a lot of the value from the skins from these collections come from their trade up potential for the red skins. You can obviously invest into a souvenir Desert Hydra with, I don't know, a Navi sticker on the scope that's going to be insane. But the thing is, you cannot trade up with skins from souvenirs, so everything undercovered will be worthless in comparison to the non-souvenir versions. So don't invest into the skins if you don't want to get the high-end skins. Invest into the cases instead. One more fun fact, if you're holding one of a valuable souvenir, unlike this Glock, maybe, I don't know, Desert Hydra, Arabesque or something like that, or actually already like the Scout Deathstrike, any good souvenir skin, if you're holding something like that, you can actually scrape down the stickers, rebuy them and replace them. So you can change the positions with every sticker but the PGL Stockholm one. This one is always in a fixed position. So if you want to rearrange your other stickers to make it look like it came in best position and maybe increase the value of it, especially on a covered skin, then check out the best sticker positions and make sure that everything is in the best place for maximum profit. I hope this video helped you out, and I will see you guys hopefully again in another video.